بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. We talk in this lectures about role of CTMR in imaging diagnosis of bowel disease. CT diagnosis of abnormal bowel wall disease can be analyzed, categorize the attenuation of bowel wall into five patterns. First pattern attenuation with no contrast, as we see circumferential thickening of the sigmoid colon. Attenuation of bowel wall is homogeneous without intravenous contrast material. Further characterization not possible. Another attenuation after intravenous contrast in C obtained 48 hours after at the same level show in second sigmoid with target configuration. Findings suggest inflammation or ischemia. This is homogeneous attenuation. What's called homogeneous attenuation pattern. Gray and white attenuation. Differential diagnosis of a second bowel wall that show homogeneous attenuation in CT includes some mucosal hemorrhage or hematoma, infarcted bowel, new glands, Crohn's disease, radiation injury, and pseudo thickening related to incomplete distension and residual fluid. This is heterogeneous, another stratified pattern of attenuation of bowel wall. Water halo sign plus fat halo sign plus black attenuations. Present in inflammation or ischemia. Present in pneumatosis. Present as striated pattern of attenuation. This heterogeneous stratified pattern. Heterogeneous mixed attenuation, final category in second rule. Gray attenuation is defined as second bowel that shows little enhancement, whose enhancement attenuation compatible with that of enhanced muscle. Common diagnosis is at least specific of five attenuation categories and is common in both benign and malignant condition. Gray attenuation, as we see, gray attenuation of the wall combined with surrounding muscles. Morphologic criteria aiding interpretation of CT scan in intestinal diseases. Characteristic benign or malignant. Ages, benign tapered, malignant hipped up, thickness, uniform, symmetric, thinner than less than 2 cm in benign. Variable asymmetric, thicker than 3 cm in malignant. Valvular convents present in benign, absent in malignant. White pattern, another pattern represent avid uniform contrast enhancement of second bowel wall that equal or greater than that of venous opacification in the same scan. Common diagnosis of the white pattern IBD, idiopathic inflammatory bowel disease, vascular disorders like bowel ischemia, bowel wall hematoma, and common diagnosis is malignancy. This is white attenuation, as we see, contrast enhancement of the wall equal to or more than venous opacification, as we see in IVC. Water halo sign, it indicates stratification within a second bowel wall. The lower attenuation layer of the water halo believed to represent edema. Double halo sign consists of inner low attenuation ring surrounded by outer high attenuation ring. Common diagnosis IBD, vascular disorder, infectious diseases, radiation damage. This is examples of water halo sign. As we see low attenuations layers due to edema at outer echogenic layer, double layer, it's water halo sign, fat halo sign. This pattern of fat halo sign refers to three layered target sign of second bowel, in which middle or submucosal layer has a fatty attenuation. In the target sign, the inner and the outer layer of high attenuation surround a central area of decreased attenuation. design are best visualized late arterial and early portal venous phase after IV contrast material enhancement. When unenhanced or delayed more than 2 minutes IVC contrast enhanced CT, the sign not be a visualized. High attenuation present with this sign related to hyperemia. It's measured in house field, largely blue, thin HU, and can be distinguished from grayer tone of water halo sign. Diagnosis of fat halo sign, idiopathic inflammatory edema disease. Fat target sign more common ulcerative colitis and Crohn's disease. This is examples of fat halo signs. As we see three layers, two echogenic in between hypo dense layer, two dense in between hypo dense layers is present as edema. Inner dense, outer dense layer. This is represents fat halo sign, target sign. Target sign in 37-year-old man with history of acute Crohn's disease, as we see inner and the outer dense layer in between hypodense layer low attenuations. This is marked circumferential thickening of the terminal ileum. The target appearance noticeable. This is exception to accepted general rule. Target sign equal inflammation. Exception to this general rule is occurrence of this sign infiltrating squamous carcinoma of the stomach and the colon. Black attenuations is equivalent of pneumatosis. Any process of injury of the bowel wall that's accompanied by prick in the mucosa and can introduce intramural gas. Common diagnosis ischemia, infection, trauma, pitfalls, confusing intramural gas with intraluminal gas. This is examples of black attenuations. As we see, black attenuations as a result of air in the wall, intramural air. This is the last type of attenuations present in investigation of bowel wall with CT contrast enhancement. Combinations of attenuation pattern may be single disease like IBD may simultaneously demonstrate different attenuation pattern in contiguous segments of the bowel. Analysis of each segment of affected small or large intestine judged by this separate category. This is heterogeneous low attenuation enhancement in mucinous adenocarcinoma. Irregular circumferential thickening seen 60-year-old man with abdominal pain. This is show a splenic flexure, irregular thickening and the vocal thickening here, low attenuation in colonic wall. Also, this is another example, gray attenuations. As we see, gray attenuations, first type of attenuations, prime malignant condition. Second one is white attenuation. Opacification equal or more than venous opacifications present in hematoma and ischemia. Another water halo signs, two double layer present inner hypo and outer hyper dense layer present infectious and radiations. This is fourth water halo sign, target sign, three layer hypo low attenuation in between two hyper attenuation layer present in IBD. Lastly, black attenuations as we see as a result of air in the wall, intramural air in pneumatosis. Degree of bowel thickening is very important. In general, benign condition result in bowel wall thickening of less than 2 cm. Whereas wall thickening greater than 3 cm usually present in neoplastic conditions. Mild thickening in cases of mild bowel thickening, non-neoplastic inflammatory infectious condition present. Marked thickening may be present in inflammation and infection or neoplasm. In neoplasm, small bowel lymphoma rarely obstruct lumen present as markedly thickened segment from 1.5 to 7 cm. in infection and inflammations, wall of the colon may be markedly thickened, and in CT finding of barium trapped between this fold, known as accordion sign. This is examples of accordion sign in 44-year-old man with diarrhea and Clostridium colitis. Contrast enhanced CT of mid abdomen to marked thickening of the ostra, as we see, and in between, as we see, perium thickened ostra mimic appearance of accordion. Thickened ostra and trapped barium in between give us accordion condition. The thickened ostra and barium, this is which is high attenuation dense, trapped between the thickened ostra, give us accordion appearance. Lymphoma variant, widespread thickening of small intestinal wall, narrow irregular thickening of the fold. This is the lymphoma variant, and lymphoma have many different conditions. Here in duodenal wall present infarction, we see a black attenuation as in ischemia. Here and the non-specific bowel wall thickening, this is another example, not related to specific type of attenuations. This is malrotation as we see, superior mesenteric vein, superior and to left of the superior mesenteric artery. Normally it is right to superior mesenteric artery. This is examples of malrotations. Also we see coronal axial CT showing low density delineated mass, low density delineated mass in duodenum and jejunum, low intensity of mass in MT1 fat set microscopic, it is liboma. This liboma, low intensity of mass, liboma, low density, low intensity mass in duodenum and jejunum. Intraluminal liboma, as we see, low attenuation, low density mass present. Another example, small bowel liboma, as we see, this is small bowel liboma in the wall of the small bowels. Schwannoma of the stomach, mass arising from wall of the stomach, exophytic to outside, homogeneous contrast enhancement, high attenuations. Schwannoma of the stomach, this is mass with low attenuation or isoattenuation, bulging inside the wall of the stomach, vocal lobular thickening, it is leiomyoma of the stomach. This is examples of extraluminal jejunal leiomyomas, small bowel leiomyomas, mass arising from the wall, globular thickening, contrast enhancement not so high, this is low attenuations. This is benign hamartomatous polyps, this is benign hamartomatous polyps, MRI of small bowel. This is giant Parnell's gland adenoma of duodenal bulb, giant Parnell's adenoma of duodenal bulb, irregular hypodense mass, not grave contrast enhancement. And this is barium studies well-defined lobular adenoma, well-defined lobular large adenoma, jejunal adenoma, as we see mass in jejunum bulging inside the wall, heterogeneous enhancement and heterogeneous density. This is axial CT show large, clearly delineated mesenterial mass, compressing IVC and proved to be desmoid tumors of mesentery. This is small hemangioma, a small mass in the wall with avid contrast enhancement, look bright in contrast enhancement, small hemangiomas, adenocarcinoma of the small bowel, this adenocarcinoma of the small bowels, irregular strictures, abrupts, not graduals, destruction of the mucosa, adenocarcinoma arising from duodenal loops with para-aortic lymph nodes, para-aortic lymph node, large mass, heterogeneous enhancement, areas of cystic degenerations, low attenuations, adenocarcinoma of the ileum, and adenocarcinoma of jejunum, and we see thickening of the wall irregular. also axial CT show second wall jejunal mass with dilated lumen proved to be adenocarcinoma. Axial CT second wall jejunal mass irregular. Adenocarcinoma causing typical apical core appearance lesions. Adenocarcinoma typical apical core appearance lesions. Gradual shortening, shouldering, irregularity, destruction of the mucosa, duodenal and jejunal gastrointestinal stromal tumor, a large mass, irregular, heterogeneous enhancement, areas flow attenuation, cystic degeneration, displacing the bowel, duodenal and jejunal gist, two cases of gist gastrointestinal stromal tumors. Also diffuse large beta cell lymphoma of the stomach, irregularity intraluminal mass, eccentric irregular thickening enhancement, diffuse large beta cell lymphoma of the stomach, the high grade beta cell lymphoma of the stomach, aneurysmal dilatation of the terminal ileum lumen along with mass effect. This is lymphoma. Small bowel follows through show diffuse nodular fold thickening of the most of the small bowel case of lymphoma. Duodenal lymphoma, bulky soft tissue mass infiltrating submucosa. Submucosal soft tissue infiltrating mass due to lymphoma. Small intestinal mass, jejunal lymphoma, ileal lymphoma. Also small bowel lymphoma, small bowel lymphoma, small bowel lymphoma, irregular thickening of the wall of the small bowel, low grade malt lymphoma of the stomach, low grade malt lymphoma of the stomach, diffuse beta cell lymphoma of the stomach, diffuse large beta cell lymphoma of the stomach, also enterobacy type 2 cell lymphoma. Enterobacy type 2 cell lymphoma. Also we see in this image enterobacy type 2 cell lymphoma. Burkitt's lymphoma seen of the small bowel. Leiomyosarcoma of the small bowel. As we see this mass in the small bowel, large irregular mass, low attenuation, heterogeneous enhancement. Also next beige carcinoid tumor of the small bowel. This is a small mass we seen. May cause intestinal obstructions, and this is a mesenteric fat like star effect. This is a carcinoid tumor of the small bowel and liver. Carcinoid tumor of the small bowel and the liver. Also, axial CT shows speculated calcified mesenterial mass with dilated small bowel loops consistent with small bowel carcinoid. Satellite mesenteric mass also through primary carcinoid tumor. Primary carcinoid tumor is cause feeling defect in the wall. Axial non-enhanced CT and diffused PET image. Two sites of wall thickening of the small bowel with marked FDG uptake in a patient with metastasized melanoma. Also axial coronal CT intercepting intraluminal mass of the small bowel on the right side present with melanoma and this is metastasis in the liver. Also we see metastasis from carcinoma breast, carcinoma of the breast metastasis to the bowel with large lymph nodes. So we talk next in about role of MRI in imaging of bowel disease, MR fluoroscopy, partial small bowel obstructions. Next images is MR bulboidal rectal tumor, MI bulboidal rectal tumors. Post gadolinium 3D hydraulic MR, as we see, circumferential irregular thickening of the bowel wall of the stomach. Crohn's disease, leiomyosarcoma of the small bowel. This leiomyosarcoma of the small bowel. sick bowel wall engorged mesentery, second bowel wall with engorged mesentery, small bowel follow through recurrent small bowel obstruction shows mucosal edema, MRI small bowel follow through mucosal edema and stricture of terminal ileum and cecum, stricture of terminal ileum and cecum causing small bowel obstructions. Coronal T1 fat sat and coronal T2 show marked enhancing clearly delineated luminal mass in the right upper quadrant. This is small bowel hemangioma. As we see, this is small bowel hemangioma. This is high signal in T2, contrast enhancement in T1, T4, SAT, coronal, small bowel hemangiomas. Axial T2 show multivocal small bowel interceptions. Multivocal small bowel interception patient with Pittsger syndromes. Small bowel interceptions, multivocals. Homogeneously enhancing bulboidal mass lesion in the Pittsger's syndromes, MRI coronal, MRI, multiple bulboidal heterogeneous enhancement masses, axial T2 show unilocular benign mass with shouldering margins in the duodenum, shouldering margin in the duodenum, unilocular benign mass, virtual endoscopy. It's another technique used for investigations of the bowel, virtual endoscopy. Virtual endoscopy may be by CT or MRI. Virtual endoscopy is value of TD image, large bulboidal intraluminal feeling defect on an induluminal 3D. This is internal density of mass is fatty. As we see into two-dimensional image, mesogenic of benign lipoma. This is another images of virtual CT endoscopy, axial CT, virtual CT endoscopy versus CT. As we see ileocecal valve lesions misinterpreted as a stool or prominent valve, CT colonoscopy, we see well bulb and we miss the fiber optic colonoscopy. This is another examples of fiber optic versus virtual endoscopy. Better visualization of entire wall, unlike blind spots in fiber optic colonoscopy. Angiography may have roles in the investigations of bowel, polyarthritis nodosa with microaneurysms, thrombangitis obliterans, narrow superior mesenteric artery, tachyasis, arthritis, narrow superior mesenteric artery, arc of Ryland's, angiography, microaneurysm, polyarthritis nodosa. Nuclear medicines may have roles in presence of concealed hemorrhage, or we don't know site of bleeding related to bowel with RBCs, obscure bleeding, small bowel carcinoid, repeated episodes of bleeding per rectum. Nuclear medicine can show extravasation for the labeled blood in a loop of ileum. Also, plain radiography summarized used in acute abdomen. Barium study for the study of mucosal pattern. CT scan screening acute etiology, etiology of wall thickening, extra intestinal causes. Endoscopy angioisotopes selected according to the conditions. Thank you.